Hey, my name's Michael, and you're watching the Dong Channel here on YouTube. I have been traveling the country with Brain Candy Live. It has been amazing. I've met hundreds of you every night, and it makes me realize how much you all care. RootMuseum.co.uk/carrotcolors. A crunchy dong, something you can do online now, guys. Put your hands in the air and flag waver like you just don't care, because this site is a lot of fun. You can either upload a file or paste a URL of an image and watch it flow in the wind. There are a few factors to change up, like whether the wind is on or off. You can even choose where it waves from. Hey, look at my dong flag flapping around. What a beauty. It looks good waving from the right, left, top, and bottom, North Carolina, Netherlands, and Netherlands Antilles. These are the three places in the world called bottom. US.geotarget.com gives you the chance to see locations in the world that share a common city name. Where are you from? I'm going to assume you're from Plonken, Liechtenstein, because it has a whopping population of less than 500 people. Oh look, there are four places in the world named Plonken. Two in Belgium, one in Liechtenstein, and one in Germany, which of course is not near the North or South Pole. Those poor poles get treated so poorly by the Mercator projection, but on Mercator Extreme, you can give them better treatment. You can avoid cutting off thousands of miles short of the poles, which is the case in normal Mercator projections, by using this map to display the infinite magnitudinal distortion as you look further away from the equator. If you write in the coordinates of the South Pole, this feature of the map is kind of, well, it's not great because it's difficult to detect distortion when looking at an abyss of ice. However, if you plug in somewhere like Nairobi, Kenya, this distortion becomes much more evident. Look at the sizes of the houses and buildings closer to the equator, and now look at them closer to your chosen location. These are some big buildings. In fact, even bigger than Spain, but of course not in real life. That's just an effect of the map's distortion. Zoom in and then out to see the distorted poles relative to the more accurately sized objects close to the equator. Now, let's roll this map back into a globe for 2050.Earth, which actually looks nothing like the map we just saw. This site has collected predictions from artists, scientists, and more, and consolidated them here. Click on the yellow hexagons to see where cities, objects, and events of the future are visualized by someone. White hexagons only show predictions. For example, if you click on this one, you can see a prediction that in 2040, there will be a large amount of new microsatellites traveling through our solar system. My prediction is that in the next few seconds, you will go to Spectrum Analyzer, which is an interesting way to see harmonics and frequency intensities. You can select one of these sounds to see it at work. Now, look at the violin. You can see that for each fundamental frequency, there are many harmonics, as represented by these brighter areas. The darker colors are indicative of lower decibel frequencies and are more difficult for your ears to detect. Other sounds have fewer harmonics, like whistling. You can upload your own sounds as well, but in order to accurately read the spectrogram, you'll need an eye for color. So go to Picker, a difficult game where you have to select the square that is a different color from the rest. Starting at level 1 can lull you into a false sense of security, but don't get too comfortable, because as it goes, it gets nearly impossible to distinguish. But if this was easy for you, then you'd probably be a great painter. So check out Fluid Paint. This is just like any other painting site. Wrong. The site emulates the texture of real paint using a variety of factors. Lower quality paint makes it look all gloopy. And look what happens when you set it to low fluidity versus high fluidity. You can change the bristle count as well as color. If your painting doesn't look like mine, well, that's just because you are as unique as the robot you choose on Robo Boogie. Your originality doesn't stop there, because you can make him dance however you'd like. I'm gonna make his head move left to right more powerfully and have his left arm swing around like this. Why not have him thrust his hips around too? Excellent. Now, Robo Boogie is a little known dong, but if you wanna visualize larger dongs, go to Icons of the Web. Here, you can type in the URL of websites and see how popular they are by their size. Links to all dongs can be found in the description down below. Please subscribe for more dongs, and as always, thanks for watching.